In this BioCast, we're going to answer the question, what is an organic molecule? Organic compounds are generally any chemical compounds that contain carbon. By this definition, simple molecules such as carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide would be defined as organic molecules. However, these simple molecules are exceptions as they behave more like inorganic molecules. Therefore, a more accurate definition of organic molecules are compounds containing both hydrogen and carbon atoms. Organic chemistry is the discipline devoted to the study of carbon-based chemistry, which is the foundation for the study of biological molecules or biomolecules. Biochemistry is the study of the chemistry of life. Its objective is to explain chemical and physicochemical processes and substances that occur within living organisms. Carbon is a very unique element in that it has four valence electrons in its outer orbital, and it can form four single covalent bonds with up to four other atoms at the same time. These atoms are usually oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur, phosphorus, and carbon itself. The simplest organic compound is methane, CH4, in which a single carbon atom binds to four hydrogen atoms. As a result of carbon's unique combination of size and bonding properties, carbon atoms can bind together in large numbers, thus producing a chain or carbon skeleton. The carbon skeleton of organic molecules can be straight, branched, or ring-shaped. Organic molecules are built on chains of carbon atoms of varying lengths. Due to carbon's high bonding capacity, no other element has the ability to form so many different molecules of so many different sizes and shapes. Biomolecules are typically large, and we call them macromolecules. Many macromolecules are formed by linking together a number of identical or very similar smaller organic molecules. The smaller molecules act as building blocks and are called monomers. And the macromolecules that result from their linkage are called polymers. A structural analogy would be a train, where the complete train represents the polymer and the individual train cars the monomers. By changing the order of the train cars, a large number of different trains can be created. Cells consist of four main groups of carbon-containing macromolecules. They are the carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids. Carbohydrates are sugars that have multiple functions and are important as an energy source, and they're structurally very important for many living organisms. For example, cellulose is an important structural fiber for plants. Lipids, or fats, are organic substances that are insoluble in water. They include fats, waxes, sterols, fat-soluble vitamins, triglycerides, and phospholipids. Lipids are not true polymers as they don't share a common monomer group. Lipids play a great role in the cellular structure like cell membranes and are the chief source of energy. Proteins make up around 50% of a living cell's dry weight. Proteins are polymers of amino acids arranged in the form of polypeptide chains. Proteins play both structural and dynamic roles in living cells. For example, myosin is the protein that allows movement by muscle contraction. And enzymes are proteins that regulate chemical reactions in cells. Nucleic acids refer to the genetic material found in the cell that carries all the hereditary information from parents to offspring. There are two types of nucleic acids, namely deoxyribonucleic acid, or DNA, and ribonucleic acid, RNA. The main function of nucleic acid is the transfer of genetic information and the synthesis of proteins in cells. The monomer unit of nucleic acids is known as a nucleotide. It is composed of a nitrogenous base, a pentose or 5-carbon sugar, and a phosphate group. Overall, the DNA structure looks similar to a twisted ladder. In summary, organic molecules are usually composed of carbon and hydrogen atoms with other atoms attached, such as oxygen and nitrogen. The structure of all organic macromolecules generally contain long chains of monomers. Most carbon-containing organic compounds found in living cells are the carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids.
Thanks for viewing this BioCast. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to check us out on the web at www.biocast.com.